Thanks for joining us. The state's largest school district could essentially shut down in a matter of months if the school board doesn't approve its budget by July 1st. And one of its members is threatening a showdown if the district doesn't get rid of a laundry list of programs around gender and racial equity. But the district says a lot of these programs are required by state law. Jennifer Hoff is here looking into what happens next. Jennifer?
Julie, this will get hashed out for the first time at a school board meeting next week after board member Matt Audette made the threat on Facebook about 5 days ago now, writing it's time to, quote, put a stop to the spreading of divisive, one-sided views and training.
The Anoka-Hennepin School District is the state's largest, serving nearly 40,000 students, like sophomore Trini Mogaka.
For me, it's more than just expressing my originality. It's having a sense of community here and not being judged by it. It's just really, it's very affirming.
A sense of inclusivity now threatened after board member Matt Audette posted this online, writing he and two other members can't vote in favor of this year's budget that funds gender and racial equity programs. And without a majority, the budget won't pass and the district can't spend any money from teacher salaries to construction projects.
I think they're just feeling so uncertain of like where this is coming from.
Jalen Giles teaches social studies that now includes ethnic studies, something Audette wrote he won't support. The district, though, citing dozens of state and federal laws that require it includes some of what he objects to.
They're wondering, are we allowed to learn this? Are we allowed to do this? And there's really nothing you can say to like comfort them, like because it's just very uncertain.
Several board members are backed by the conservative Minnesota Parents Alliance that says education is at a crossroads, vowing to help parents organize and change its trajectory.
But that's not what the purpose is. The lasting impact in what is being communicated to our diverse families in this district is that you are insignificant, you don't get a voice.
It's 2024 and we are taking like 5 steps back when we should be evolving and moving forward.
Only 2 board members responded to our interview request, not including Audette, writing only in a statement that no decisions have been made on any of this and discussions will continue next week. If this budget doesn't pass, it will be unlike anything that has happened in our state before, as the district, by the way, is grappling with a pretty big budget deficit, and it has to make some $25 million in reductions, Julie, over the next couple of years. So a lot of things in limbo here tonight.
Thank you, Jennifer.